Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Santeria is a popular religious movement originating in Cuba that combines African and Roman Catholic themes. Santeria, the Way of the Saints, developed among African slaves in Cuba, and has spread throughout the Caribbean and the United States. In it, Catholic saints are identified with traditional African deities, mainly Yoruba from the area that is now Nigeria and Benin, and worshipped in colorful rites that include vegetable and animal sacrifices. Santeria altars and costumes are often magnificent works of art. The most impressive ceremonies are those in which the deities, called orishas, mount, or possess initiated devotees. The possessed one will then speak and act in ways characteristic of that god. The rites by which a devotee becomes an initiate of a particular deity, able to mediate that god through possession, are long and elaborate, involving a lengthy period of isolation and instruction. On the other hand, many people use simple everyday Santeria practices for divination and luck. Santeria has flourished in the late 20th and early 21st centuries, both in Cuba, despite the Revolution of 1959, and in the United States, where Cuban exiles have made it a presence in most major metropolitan areas. Although it has occasionally been controversial in the United States because of its use of animal sacrifice and alleged magical practices, it appears to be well established and has drawn some non-Cuban adherents. Similar in practice to Vodun, Santeria centers around the worship of the ancient African gods who have been assimilated as Catholic saints. Santeria comes from the Spanish word santo, meaning saint. Practitioners are called santeros, female, santeras. Like Vodun, Santeria came to the Americas with the millions of black slaves from West Africa, principally from the Yoruban tribes along the Niger River. Forced to convert to Catholicism, the slaves continued their religion in secret, passing along ancient traditions either orally or in handwritten notebooks that came to be called libretas. Gradually, the Yorubans began to see what they believed were the incarnations of their gods and the Catholic saints and syncretized the two faiths. The slaves' Spanish and Portuguese masters eventually grew fascinated with Yoruban magic and began to practice it themselves. Today, any city with a large Hispanic population probably boasts as many santeros as devout Catholics, since many of the devotees practice both. New York, Miami, Los Angeles, and the nations of Cuba and Jamaica all have Santeria strongholds. Brazilians also practice Santeria but under the names of Candomblé, Umbanda, and Quimbanda. Although all worshippers of Santeria could be called santeros, the term usually refers to the priests or priestesses. The highest order of priest is a babalawo, who has power not only to heal the sick and punish the unjust but to divine the future through the table of Ifa. All babalawos are male, as Orunla, god of the table of Ifa, is male. Within the order of babalawo are various degrees, ranging from high priest to the one responsible for a particular orisha's sacrifice. Following the babalawo are the priests of orishas who govern the sick or healing, and the priests or priestesses of orisha oko, the god of agriculture. Priests consecrated to lesser orishas or human deities also fall in this third category. The power of the babalawo is limitless, as he wears the hats of healer, diviner, judge, pastor, matchmaker, and magician. The babalawo's second most important duty is sacrificing animals as offerings to the orishas. Common sacrificial animals include all types of fowl, chickens, roosters, pigeons, doves and other birds, goats, pigs and occasionally bulls.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.